Greetings, I'm Dr. Kim Young-won of Online Surgery. I am honored to speak with you about surgery today. I'm going to talk briefly about today's surgery. 57-year-old male patient, if you look over here, number 14 is missing. There's no special medical history. However, it has been approximately 6 months since number 14 was extracted. Extraction was done in a separate dental clinic and the patient came in for implant treatment. I took CT. It has been approximately 6 months since extraction and there's somewhat bone healing within the socket. Because there was alveolar bone destruction before extraction, there is a little bit of radiolucency in medullary portion. However, alveolar bone thickness, there's no major issue. It's upper premolar, so I'm going to place the implant slightly palatally. I plan to place K3 because it is premolar. The diameter is going to be 4.5 by 10 millimeter. It has been approximately 6 months since extraction. However, I anticipated bone to be soft and final drilling is going to be done up until 4.0. There will be no major issue in placing 4.5 KS3 implant. This is post-op image. The primary stability was very good and healing abutment was connected. If you look at the CT, as mentioned earlier, the implant was slightly palatally inclined to get more primary stability from the heart bone on the palatal side. Buccally, the alveolar bone thickness is approximately 3 millimeter, and therefore no additional bone graft was done. This was fairly simple surgery. Let's look at the surgical video clip. This is upper premolar, and I planned for palatally inclined implant placement. Crystal incision is made slightly palatally. In order to get the drill hole position, I'm using a lens drill. Twisted drill is used and drilling is done up until 10 millimeter and then parallel pin is placed to check the path with antagonist. Implant has been placed slightly palatally because it's upper premolar and it is facing the buccal cusp, functional cusp of lower molar. Depth gauge is used to check for perforation or fenestration on the apex side. After that, 3.5 by 10 millimeter 1-2 taper drill is used. For final drill. The original plan was to place 4.5 by 10 millimeter implant, KS3BA surface, diameter 4.5 by 10 millimeter. Implant is being placed. This is hydrophilic implant, so you need to sufficiently irrigate it with saline. Torque wrench is used to adjust the final depths. Primary stability is good. It's over 30 newton centimeter. As you can see, it is placed slightly palatally. The antagonist relation is checked once again. It is facing the functional cusp of antagonist. It It has been placed sufficiently deep, 1 to 2 millimeters from the alveolar bone. Smart peg is connected to measure the AISQ value. In OSSTEM beacon, it's approximately 73. Primary stability is stable. Healing abutment is connected and surgery has been completed. This was a simple case. Interrupted suture was done. The surgery was completed fairly simply. It was upper premolar case. It had been 6 months since extraction, and I placed the implant slightly more palatally. No additional bone graft was necessary, and surgery was completed very simply. Thank you for watching.